أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم In the name of Allah, the most beneficent and the most merciful. Dear students, welcome in Pakistan International School Thai, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia, Virtual Learning System Session 2020. This is English for Grade 6. Name of the book is Around the World in 80 Days. Today is lecture number 26, chapter number 3, Fix the Detective shows a very natural impatience, reading and exercise. We'll do the reading and exercise. I'm your teacher, Adnan Sabir Mirza. Dear students, the novel is getting interesting day by day. And this shows the writing skill of Jules Verne, that is the name of the writer, Jules Verne. So here we go to the next chapter, chapter number 3, page number 25, which the detective shows a very natural impatience. A week after Phyllis Bowles' departure, an incident occurred that deprived him of all backers at any price. Backers means the people who were backing him, were supporting him. And deprive means to get rid of or to make him someone without something. The commissioner of police received the following telegram in his office, which read, telegram is was in some country it is, but it was almost was the fastest way of communication at that time to send the message from one place to another. Now we can send the message in second on WhatsApp. But at that time, the telegram was used with the national post offices. So the message was, Suze to London. It was sent from Suze, River Suze, and it was sent to London. Row 1, Commissioner of Police, Scotland Yard. I have found the bank robber, Phileas Fogg. Send without delay an arrest warrant to Bombay. Fix detective. So he sent the message to the commissioner of police that Phileas Fogg is the robber of the bank. So send a warrant to arrest him. The effect of the telegram was instantaneous. Instantaneous means without any delay. The picture of Phileas Fogg as an honorable gentleman disappeared at once to give place to that of a bank robber. In the mind of the people, his photograph was minutely examined to the description of the robber provided by the police. The mysterious and solitary habits of Phileas Fogg were recalled. It seemed clear that he had left the country on the pretext of a wager to evade the detectives and throw them off his track. So they were thinking that he is pretending to do the betting with his friends. Actually, he want to escape and he want to detract the detectives. The circumstances which the arrest warrant was dispatched were as follows. The steamer Mongolia, that is the name of the steamer, the ship, was due at 11 a.m. on Wednesday, the 9th of October in Suez. Two men were waiting impatiently at the waves. One was a British consul in Sils, who saw the English ships passing daily to and from on the Great Canal. The other was a thin man who wore a worried expression. He was fixed means his name was fixed. Actually, he was a detective. One of the detectives who had look at the picture of the counsel and the detective. Was means structure enabling ships to load and unload, to and fro, backward and forward. Being sent from England in search of the bank robber. It was his task to keep watch on the passengers who arrived on the steamer. The Mongolia and follow up every passenger who bore a resemblance to the description of the robber, which he had received 2 days before from the police headquarters in London. Is the steamer late, sir? Asked for the 20th time. Have patience, Mr. Fix. She will not be late, but I really don't see how you will be able to recognize your man, even if he is on the Mongolia, said the consul. You must have sixth sense to feel the presence of robbers. I have arrested more than one of these robbers in my time. And if my robber is on the board, he will not slip through my finger, said Fix. I hope so, Mr. Fix, said the consul. As the time passed by, activity began to increase on the quay. Quay means landing place for loading and unloading ships. And consul, a state official living in foreign country and protecting the state citizens and their interests there. As the time passed by, activity began to increase on the quay. The arrival of the steamer was close. It was now 10:30. How long will she stop at Sils? Asked Fix. 4 hours. She has to take a fresh supply of coal. She will then proceed directly to Bombay, replied the consul. After some time, the consul went away to his office, leaving Mr. Fix with some food for thought means thinking that he might get any idea while being alone. So after the Mongolia arrived and anchored means when the ship was on the harbor, the professionals used to tie them with anchors. Anchor is a heavy iron arrow type thing which is thrown into the bottom of the water or sea or river. So that the ship cannot move. Maybe sometimes they are 2 or 4 to stop the movement with the air and waves. Fix, thinking his place, carefully examined each and every passenger leaving the steamer. Suddenly, one of the passengers came up to him and asked if he could point out the English consulate. He showed Fix a passport. Fix took the passport and read the description of its bearer. He was stunned, for the description in the passport was identical with that of the robber. Stunned means surprised. Description details. "Is this your passport?" asked Fix to the passenger. "No, it's my master's," replied the passenger. "He's on board." "Your master must go to the consulate in person so as to establish his identity," said Fix, pointing to a building 200 steps off. "I'll go and get my master," said the passenger. The passenger took leave of Fix and made his way back to the steamer. Soon after, the detective rushed to the consul office. On entering the office, Fix cried, "Consul, I have strong reason to believe that my man is a passenger on the Mongolia." And Fix told the consul all about the passenger and the passport. "Well," Mr. Fix, replied the consul, "the robber will not come here. A robber does not like to leave the traces of his flight behind him. If he is a shrewd fellow," "I think he is. He will surely come," said Fix. "Means he, if he is a clever one, he will definitely come," Fix was of the view. "To have his visa?" "Yes, passports are of great help to robbers. I hope you will not give him a visa," asked Fix. "Why not? If the passport is genuine, I have no right to refuse," replied the consul. "I have to keep this man until I get an arrest warrant from London." "That's your business, but I cannot." The consul did not finish his sentence when a knock was heard at the door. Two men entered, one of whom was a servant whom Fix had met on the quay, and the other was his master, who held out the passport to the consul with request to give him a visa. "You are Mr. Philipsburg from London on way to Bombay?" asked the consul. "Yes, sir," replied Mr. Fogg. "Sir, do you know that for going to Bombay, you do not require a passport, and even a visa is useless?" "I know, sir, but I wish to prove by the visa that I came to service," replied Philipsburg. "Very well, sir," said the consul. The consul signed and dated the passport and stamped it with his official seal. Phileas Fogg paid the customary fee, bowed, and went out, followed by Passepartout. "He seems to be an honest man," said the consul. "I will get to the bottom of this," said Fix. Soon after, Fix excused himself and went in search of Passepartout. Meanwhile, Phileas Fogg, after leaving the consulate, gave some orders to Passepartout, went on board, and sat down in his cabin. He took out his notebook, which contained the following details: left London Wednesday, October 2nd at 8:45 p.m. Reached Paris Thursday, October 3rd at 7:20 a.m. Left Paris Thursday at 8:40 a.m. Reached Turin by Mont Cenis Friday, October 4th at 6:35 a.m. Left Turin Friday at 7:20 a.m. Arrived at Brindisi Saturday, October 5th at 4 p.m. sailed on Mongolia Saturday at 5 p.m. Reached Suez Wednesday, October 9th at 11 a.m. Total of hours spent 158 and a half or 6 days and a half. These dates indicate the actual arrival at each principal point, Paris, Brindisi, Suez, Bombay, Calcutta, Singapore, Hong Kong, Yokohama, San Francisco, New York, and London. From the 2nd of October to the 21st of December. Next to each was the space to write down the gain or loss suffered on arrival at each port. This methodical record always showed Mr. Fogg whether he was behind or ahead of his schedule or schedule. On his arrival on October 9th, and so he saw that he had neither gained nor lost. So this was the end of reading of chapter number 3. Now we are moving towards the exercise. Alhamdulillah Ta'ala, we have done the reading of 3 chapters. Answer the following questions. What was the effect of the telegram? This is question number 1. Answer: the telegram affected the reputation of Phileas Fogg. It changed from honorable gentleman to a bank robber. Number 2. What were the circumstances under which the arrest warrant was dispatched by Fix? The steamer Mongolia was due at 11 a.m. on Wednesday 9th of October in Suez. Number 3. What was the itinerary of Mr. Fogg's voyage? The itinerary of Mr. Fogg's voyage was from London to Paris, Brindisi, Suez, Bombay, Calcutta, Singapore, Hong Kong, Yokohama, San Francisco, New York, and then London again. This was question answer. Now the next exercise is exercise 2. Match the following words in list A with their antonyms in list B. Antonyms are opposites. So first of all, you will do the exercise 1 question answer. You will write the question number wise and the answers in your notebooks, and then do this on the book first, then do the matching of the column, then do in your copies, notebooks, write the words, and in front of the word write matching word. Actually, it is opposite word. Gain, loss. Departure, arrival. Presence, absence. Liquid, solid. Genuine, counterfeit. Identical, different. Honest, deceitful. Now, next is use of any 5 of the following words and sentences of your own. Arrest, provide, intelligence, refuse, request, details. These are done below. Next question is who speak these words and to whom, when, and why. Have patience, she will not be late. But I really don't see how you will be able to recognize your name. I think these are the words of the course. Number 2, I know it, sir, but I wish to prove by the visa that I come by Suez. These words were said by Phileas Fogg. So first, Use any five of the following sentences in your own sentence of your own. Arrest, police arrested the thief. Provide, the government is trying to provide everything needed by the people. Intelligent, Ahmed is an intelligent boy. Refuse, Ali refused to give up. He request, teacher accepted my request. Details, please provide details about where you live. Who speaks these words? Consul said to Mr. Fix, when Mr. Fix asked for 20th time if the steamer was late. Number two, Mr. Fo said to his said this to counsel when counsel told him that he does not need any visa to go to Bombay. This is all. This is all about the lesson. And dear students, if you really want to enjoy, let me tell you again to do the reading of these three chapters again, then you will have better understanding. Dear students, this is very interesting story. When you establish a habit of reading, believe me, it is something like you are watching a movie. Even in movies, sometimes you miss something, but in the novel, it is a quality that whatever the writer want to show you, you will see. And you will feel what he want you to feel. If he is giving you entertainment, you will get it. If he is giving you thrill, if he is making you sad, making you anxious, you will live with him. So it is very important to establish a better understanding by doing the reading again and again. So this is all for today. Inshallah, see you in the next chapter. Till then, take care of yourself, take care of your loved ones, dear ones, and keep the social distance. We are still fighting with Corona. Be careful, sanitize your hands, use the facial mask, and don't try to mix with the strangers. So goodbye, bye bye, assalamu alaikum, take care.